So very good evening to one and all. Good evening, children. Today we are going to discuss about intermediate first year economics. First year economics, third chapter, demand analysis. Okay, so demand analysis. So let us first discuss the meaning of demand. What do we mean by demand? Children, what do you think? The word demand and desire, whether these two words are same? Okay, so these two words, desire and demand, are not same, children. Why? What is a demand? Desire, that we demand, what we say, that we need it. But the desire, it remain as a desire only, children, till we have the ability to pay for it. For example, what is a demand, children? Demand here, it means the consumer, the desire that is backed up by the willingness. Desire that is backed up by the willingness and ability to pay a sum of money for some quantity of a good and service. Means, if we have a desire, the desire will not become a demand till we are having a willingness to pay and ability to pay for the goods and services. That means two things are coming. That is willingness and ability. Then only that desire will be called as demand. Simple one. One poor person is there. If he desire to go to some other place by air, that is by aeroplane, if he desire to go to some other country, international countries, that is his desire. But can we say that his desire will turn as a demand? Because a poor person, he is not having that much of money to pay the charges for the aeroplane tickets. Okay, So that desire remains desire only. That is his wish only, but he is unable to pay for it. Suppose if we desire to live in a big bungalow, big palace, but we are not having enough money to live in that palace. We are not having that money to purchase that palace. That means we are not having ability. How can it become a demand? So I think it is clear to you. Demand is what? When you are desiring of something and with the same you are willing to pay for it and you are having ability also to pay for it. That we called as demand. Again, look after the definition. Desire backed up by willingness. Backed up by willingness and ability to pay a sum of money for some quantity. For some quantity of goods and services. That we call as demand. Now, so children, there are certain features are there for demand. What are the features that we understood from this particular definition? The features are desire for a commodity. We should wish to have that commodity. That is a desire to have that commodity. Next, that commodity should always have a price. Everything, whatever we are demanding, children, most of the thing are having its price in the market. So the demand is having price. We have to pay the price. Okay. We have to desire for a commodity. And that too we have to pay the price. When we have to pay the price, when we are willing to pay the price and the demand is going on changing per day, per month, per year. That means whatever we are demanding today, it's not necessary that the same demand will continue tomorrow or after 1 month. The demand goes on changing. That's what demand is changing per unit of time. We can find per day demand is changing. We can find per month it's changing. Per year it's changing. According to season it is changing. So demand every time goes on changing. So what are the children? The features are there. The features are the desire for the commodity. Demand is always at a price. Then willingness to pay the price. We should have the willingness to pay, children. Then demand is per time, per day, per unit, per year. So this is called as, children, the features of demand. So after learning the features of demand, children, we have to learn, children, now about demand function. What is demand function? So now children, this is a demand function. So demand function, what is a demand function? So demand function is nothing but this is a, it shows a relationship between the quantity demanded. Shows a relationship between the quantity demanded of a commodity and the factors that determine it. What is demand function? This is very important from the examination point of view. So what is demand function? Demand function is nothing but it shows a relationship between the quantity demanded of a commodity. How much of the quantity we are demanding. Okay. And its relationship with the factors that determine that quantity. So it will be better explained by the help of this following equation. What is this? You can observe here. It is written as dx is equal to f into px, ps, pc, y and t. What it shows that if you demand this d, dx is demand for the good x. So demand for the good x, this demand depends on the price of the good, price of substitute, price of complementary, income of the consumer and the taste of the consumer. Okay, so what does it mean? Dx is a demand for a good x, px is a price for that good x, ps is a price of substitutes, then pc is a price of complementary, y is the income of the consumer, t stands for taste of the consumer, and f is nothing but the functional relationship. That means any commodity that we demand depends upon all these factors. Now we'll discuss one by one. Okay. So whatever the things we demand, so demand depends on all these factors. Price of goods, substitute, price of complementary, then income and the taste of the consumer. I hope it is clear. So this is very important 2 marks question for you. Demand function that shows the relationship between the quantity demanded and the factors that determine it. Okay, so now we will discuss about all the things children one by one, that is determinants of demand. Our next topic is determinants of demand. Okay, so what are the determinants of demand are there? We have to discuss that one now. So determinants. So this determinants of demand is also an important question. What are the determinants? Determinants is nothing but factors that determine the demand. So the first one is price of the commodity. First one is price of the commodity. Second one. The second one is the price of substitutes and complementaries. Price of substitutes and complementaries. Substitutes and complementaries. Then income of the consumer. Next one is income of the consumer, followed by taste and preference. Taste and preference of the consumer. That is the fourth one. Fifth one is population. Fifth one is population. Sixth one is technological changes. Technological changes is sixth one, and the last one is, that is change in weather. Change in weather. Change in weather. And the last eighth one is, it is about style of business. It is about style of business. So these are all called as the determinants of demand. So one by one children will discuss it. So the first one is price of commodity. First one is price of commodity. Now, so children, the demand depends on all these factors. Determinants means demand depends on price of commodity, price of substitutes and complementaries, income, taste and preferences, population, technological changes, then change in weather and style of business. Then price of commodity. How can we say that price of commodity, it affects the demand? Very simple one. The demand for any commodity depends on price. We can also say that the demand for commodity is inversely proportional to the price. Demand for any commodity is inversely proportional to the price. What does it mean? When we find that the demand for any goods are more, the prices less. And when demand is less, we find prices more. That means both are moving against to each other. So that when demand increase, price decrease. When demand decrease, price increase. Vice versa. It moves in a vice versa. So we can say that it is negative. It is inversely relation. We can say it is an inverse relation to each other. Okay. So this is the first one. Any example you can take it, children. The demand for any good. Suppose if we find that we are in need of one or the other product. When we are in need of one or the other product, we find that we first come to know about the price of the product. If we find the price is very less, then we demand more. If we find the price is less, we demand more. If we find price is very high, then we'll purchase in a little quantity. That means our purchase, our demand depends on price. Okay, so that one we can say that the demand depends on price. If price is more, demand is less. If price is less, demand will be more. That is inverse relationship. So that is called as price of a commodity. Now, next one, the price of substitutes and complementaries. Price of substitutes and complementaries. So we can say that demand depends on depends on substitutes. Demand for any good depends on substitutes. What do we mean by substitutes? Substitutes, children. Substitutes, it means that in place of the original, whatever we take it. Suppose if we are in need of toothpaste, so what we do, we go to the market, and there we come to know that the regular toothpaste, whatever we purchase, that regular brand is of high cost. So what we have to do it, we are not having that much amount of money to purchase that toothpaste. So instead of our regular brand toothpaste, we prefer another toothpaste. Okay. So that means substitutes are helpful to us. So our demand depends on substitutes. If suppose in the market we are in need of one product, but for that product there is no other substitutes are there. Similar products are not available. By any cost we have to purchase that good. But when we go to the market, we find that there are number of products are available. So the good that we want to purchase, it is costly, we purchase the another one. So that is called as substitutes. Okay. So for example, if we take it about demand depends on substitutes. Suppose we find that the demand for coffee increase. We find that the price of coffee increase. So people, what they do, they start taking tea. People usually they prefer coffee, but suddenly what happened, the cup of coffee is coming very costly. So people, they want to drink something hot. So what they do, immediately they stop drinking coffee and they start taking tea. So what it shows, when the price increase, so this is a substitute in this case, when the price increase for one product, immediately we start demanding for its substitutes. If I am the person, I am the consumer, of Colgate toothpaste. But when I go to the market, I find that that toothpaste is costly now. So what I do, I'll stop purchasing the Colgate toothpaste and instead of that, I'll purchase the Close-Up toothpaste. That is cheaper to Colgate. Clear? So what it shows, when the price of one product increase, automatically its substitute demand will increase. So here both are increasing, children. When both are increasing, we call this one as a positive relationship. We call this one as positive relationship. So in case of substitutes, we find that there is a positive relationship. Now, what is complementary then? What is complementary? Complementary means the usage of one good depends on the other good. Usage of one good depends on the usage of other good. For example, we can take the example of bike and petrol. We can take the example of bike and petrol. We find that sometime whenever there is a high prices for the bike. High prices for the bike and less petrol will prices for the petrol. Generally people, what they do? The people, they purchase the bike, but with the same, they use the bike as it is according to their wish. But in the case when we find that petrol prices increase, when we find the petrol prices increase, so in that case we find that people, they stop using bikes more. Because you know they have to get more petrol for their bike. So instead of using bike, they use bicycles. So that means this is complementary. The price of one good depends upon the usage of other good. This is called as, children, the price of substitutes and complementaries. That means demand for a good depends on substitutes. Demand for goods depends on complementaries. Now, after this one, the third one is income. The third one is income. How can you say that income is responsible for the demand for the good? Children, suppose if anyone gets an income, so based on the income, the people, what they do, they are habituated of purchasing a few goods. For example, suppose a person is there whose salary is very less. So a person can purchase only those goods, those items, those products which he can purchase in that limited income. Okay, maybe some inferior products he purchased. But when the person's salary increase, so what do you think, the person will purchase the same products? No. Instead of that, he'll try to go for some superior products. He wants to purchase somewhat superior products. That means what it shows that any person demand in the market depends on his or her income. If income is low, his demand is low products. If income is high, his demand is high quality product. That means income is affecting the demand, children. So what we can say that increase in income, increase in income, it helps to increase in the demand for the superior products. Demand for the superior goods. Also, we can say like that. So, increase in income leads to the increase in the purchasing power. And with this purchasing power, the person purchased superior goods instead of inferior goods. Inferior means low products. Inferior means low product. So, this is income. Now, after the income, what is the next one, children? The next one is taste and preference. The next one is taste and preference. What is this taste and preference? So, how can we say that the taste and preference of a consumer, it is helpful or it creates demand, children? Taste and preference, we can say that as there is a change in the taste of a person, preferences or the fashions, we find that the demand for the particular commodity may change. So we can say that demand for goods change with the change of taste, preference and fashion. Do you have any example with you? What example we can give it on this one? So the example is, once upon a time, you observe that there was a fashion of wearing dhotis. But do you find that today's generation, they would likely to wear dhotis all the time, 24 hours? No. As the fashion changed, the demand for dhoti decreased and demand for trousers increased, like pants, jeans and etc. What it shows, the demand changes as the taste and preference of the person change. So that is called as taste and preference. That is taste and preference. Now, after the taste and preference, children, we have the next one, that is population. What do you think? The population is helpful to change the demand? Yes. As population increase, as it increase, we find that demand for goods also increase. How is it possible? We find that as the population increase, demand for food increase, demand for cloth increase, demand for basic necessities increase. That means our demand depends on the increase of population. Okay, that is population. Next, after the population, we are having the next one is technological changes. We find that technological changes. Do you feel that the technological changes are helpful for the change in the demand, or demand depends on this one? Yes. How can we say based on this about the technological changes? So technological changes, we can say that yes, as the technology change, we find that the demand for the particular goods also change. For example, once upon a time, in almost all in every family, we find that there was a landline phones. Landline phones were there. But we find as the time change, as the technology change, now we find the landline phones are replaced by mobile phones. Okay, the technological changes that mobile phones are changing, are giving less preference to comparing to the landlines. So landlines, we can say that instead of this, we can say that in the olden times, landlines were there, but now landlines were replaced by mobiles. So this we can say as the technological changes also helpful to change the demand. Next one, change in weather. Do you feel that the change in weather also change in the demand? Yes. On what basis we can say that? Simple one, children. Change in weather. As you find that now this is our winter season is going on. So in this winter season, what you demand? You demand all the woolen clothes. In summer season, what you demand? You demand only cotton clothes. Based on the season also, children, you demand change. Winter season, you would likely to have everything in a hot way. And in the summer season, you would likely to have very cool, chilled ice creams or cool drinks. That means your demand is changing with a change in weather. Okay. And the last one, children, now with us, we are having the state of business. So, at the time of prosperity, we find more demand will be there. At the time of prosperity, more demand will be there. And at the time of recession, at the time of depression, we can say that. At the time of depression, we find that it will be less demanded. What is a good example that we can take it from recent situation? It is pandemic, corona, COVID-19. So what we find that when there was no corona was there, no pandemic situation was there, in the country everything was available at a proper price. Easily it was available. Okay, that was prosperity time. But at the time of depression, we find that for each and everything we used to struggle. We struggled and still we are struggling. That means everything depends on your business. So, and when it is prosper, when it is very flourished, nourished, you will get more demand. When it is at the time of depression, there is no demand for the product because of many problems. So children, these are all called as the determinants of demand. A very important 4 marks question, 5 marks questions for you. Okay, so I hope that everything is clear to all of you. Okay, so you know what the work you have to do it, to read the lesson, go through the material. And if you want to improve your knowledge, go through any other resources if you want to go through. So now it's a time to leave, children. Thank you. Thank you, one and all, children. Thank you.